GPT4o mini just came out and it's all the rage in the AI internet, but we're going to test it out in this channel, whether it's good enough for you to start doing SEO, your copywriting and everyday task. We're going to do that by running a little test and we're going to run it side by side with GPT4o, the normal version, Claude Sonnet 3.5, and then we're going to test GPT4o mini by doing the same thing with all three language models. The test is going to be very easy. We're going to give it this little prompt, which is just telling it to act like an SEO content writer professional and take the following research, which we're going to give it, and write a 1,000 word blog written in HTML and making sure that it backlinks using the sources appropriately that we're going to give it. I've done some very quick research with using Perplexity. If you haven't used it, I highly recommend it. In my opinion, it's the best search engine out there. And I've just copied all of the components to it and pasted them here so you can see, you know, what the future of SEO looks like. It's just a little bit of research. And then most importantly, it's got the citations at the bottom. So we're gonna see which language model kind of writes everything best. And we're going to measure a couple of things. One is the word count proximity, meaning which one of the language models gets closest to 1,000 words. Two is keeping on track with the context. So it needs to provide a fresh outlook on this content. And then four, just to make sure they can do technical coding, is making sure that it actually embeds the citations that I've asked it to do when appropriate to do so. I'm going to go to ChatGPT and we're going to use GPT4o first. We're going to get our prompt that we're going to use for all this example. Go back and you can see that I've got 4o selected. I'm going to copy it here and I'm going to just give it the research and paste that research here. Now, there are probably better ways to test this out, but this is a quick and easy way, and because I'm using it for copywriting every day, for me, this makes sense. By the way, there's many ways that we can prompt each one of the language models. This is a one-shot prompting, meaning we're asking it to do everything in the one go. You can do chain of thought prompting where you give it a couple of messages outlining what you want it to do and then to write the whole thing. Sometimes different language models act better with different prompting styles. So whilst it's writing our blog already, it looks like 4o is doing it quite okay. We're going to do the same thing and go to Claude 3.5 Sonnet and see if that will start writing everything for us. We're just going to do one shot, everything's pasted, see what it does, and it's writing the HTML there, much like 4o normal. Now we're going to go back. Cool, looks like 4o is finished. I'm going to copy the output here and paste it in the appropriate Google form that I've created. So it's the HTML output. Perfect, it's done everything that we've asked it to. In a second, we're going to ask it to review the preview. Looks like Claude has finished it as well. We're going to get the code for it and copy the element and paste it in Claude Sonnet 3.5, the Google Doc that I've created. And now we're gonna go and do everything on our new version, which is Mini 4o. We're gonna get everything ready here. We're gonna go back to our ChatGPT. Just gonna copy the prompt that I gave the other one so I don't have to go back. Gonna create a new chat, change the language model up here to 4 Mini. And paste it. And already you can see that Mini is vastly quicker, which is great. And I've been using it, and so far for many of the tasks that I'm using, it is very, very good. I'm more excited within the API aspect of it because it can do 99% of the things that I needed to do, but it is a lot cheaper. So it's done everything pretty much as I have asked it to do. I'm gonna copy this and go back to where I've got everything ready. I've got Mini here, perfect. And let's not forget that it's actually did in my meta description as well. Perfect. So let's see them as they would look like in a document. So I'm going to go to a preview tool. So the word count for GPT4o mini is not very close to what we've asked it to do. It's only gotten 635 words, so not very close there. Probably needs quite a bit. Let's see the word count with GPT4o, and GPT4o is no better. It's 589 words, and this happens all the time with ChatGPT. I find that the word counting is never really up to scratch. You need to continuously remind it where you want to get to. Mind you, for an SEO perspective, it's not about word count, but it's the quality of the content. So even if it's shorter, that's okay. But still, it's something that is not really paying attention to that part of the instruction. Let's check out Claude. Claude, a lot closer here with 838 words out of the 1,000 that we've asked it to do. And the way that it's formatted everything is right up to scratch. It's backlinked the components. You can see here that it's done it correctly. It's backlinking to all the items that we're asking it to, which is pretty good. And the formatting looks quite nice. Whereas this is GPT4o, the normal version, it just doesn't backlink everything as nicely. It does if you really prompt it to do so, but you can see that it's just outlined it like last numbers at the end. That's not really what I want. I want it to backlink in the actual word instead of giving the source and the number there. And 4o mini has actually done a better job than GPT4o when it comes to backlinking everything appropriately. You can see here that it's done that correctly. So not bad at all. GPT4o mini also gave me a meta description, and so did Claude as well. So look, when it comes down to it, I think 4o mini can probably do 95% of the tasks that you need, particularly when it comes to copywriting and everything else. Particularly using its API is vastly cheaper. I would consider using 4o mini when it comes to simple tasks, particularly if using the API key. The copywriting for 4o mini is pretty good. Comparing it to the normal 4o is pretty much up to standard. I'd have to read the whole thing and provide a much longer context, but this is pretty good. I think for, like I said, most of the tasks, it's kind of there. It's pretty good for 4o mini, this one here. I like it. I'm definitely gonna be using it a lot more. If you wanna see other tests or you have any idea on how to test this out more appropriate, leave it below in the comments, and I'd love to make that video for you. Again, thanks for watching. Peace.